Marshall recently contested the final two legs of the World Championships in Malaysia and Singapore. Well, before taking on the Asian leg, Bailey won the French Grand Prix and is being tagged a World Champ of the future in what has to be one of the most exciting shows on water.
Water, there are a few more exciting or dangerous sights than a Formula One machine in full flight. The margin for error is minimal. The cost of overstepping the line is high.
Go, take her away, please. Go away.
I can't pretend that it doesn't look nasty as far as Guido Cavallini is concerned. We hope he's okay, but he is certainly being taken immediately to hospital.
Cavallini escaped with a broken arm, but he wasn't the only casualty from the final two rounds of the World Championship in Penang and Singapore. With the title far from decided, drivers were pushing their limits. Some, like John Jones, pushed too hard. Jones's Mercury-powered Burgess is considered the most powerful craft on the circuit. Keeping it on the water, though, is the tough part. This season, he came to grief in Penang. 2 years ago, it was the final race in Singapore. The Asian leg, certainly not without incident. Australian Craig Bailey came to Penang with a chance of winning the world title. The Sydney youngster, racing on a restricted budget, shocked the big guns with a victory in France. His first Grand Prix win and a sign for the future.
I feel if I can sort of sit in the mid-pack for a little while and just wait and see what happens in the beginning of the race and hopefully gradually feed my way through the field, I think I'd be happy just with a good result here and back up for Singapore next weekend.
Joining him from Australia is the only woman on the circuit, Kay Marshall. The Asian leg, her first tangle with the best on offer.
But I've been over here, this is my fourth year. The other 3 years were to watch. This year it's to play with the boys.
After the second restart in Penang, it was Great Britain's Andy Elliott who made a charge for the lead with Bailey right on his hammer. Elliott went on to win from the fast-finishing John Hill to make it a Great Britain double.
Halfway through, I must admit, I didn't see John. I was looking behind and I saw Craig Bailey. And I did ease up a little bit and then I saw John behind me. So I thought, oh Christ, I have to go fast now, and I didn't really want to, and I kept thinking, shall I, shan't I? I got a bit out of shape, and I thought it's silly to ruin it by crashing. I should be happy with second, but I thought I'd give it a last try and cut him off a few corners, and he dropped back and he gave me a bit of breathing space, but it was fun. He was pushing hard.
Bailey suffered electrical problems, his steering wheel giving him bad electrical shocks, but he battled on for fourth, his dream of a world title slipping further away. All Kay Marshall could do was look forward to Singapore after hulling her boat. The monsoon rain threatened to disrupt the Singapore race. For Marshall, though, she was determined to make amends.
You were running very well in Penang when you hit some debris in the water, which took you out. Do you think you'll be able to get the same performance here, or do you think this very, very high humidity is going to limit the engine power?
Well, the humidity, I think, will be much the same as Penang. We've tried a new Mickey Mouse system. That's our problem this morning, and Mickey Mouse has let us down. So I think we'll go back to the way we were in Penang when we were running really well.
But this was not going to be a happy race for the Australians. Marshall suffered battery problems, while Bailey was forced out on lap 15. He had enough points, though, to finish the series in eighth spot, a tremendous result considering he only contested four rounds of the championship. Singapore was a battle of the Brits once more, this time John Hill reversing the roles with Andy Elliott to win the race and the World Championship.
It's a sweet victory, this is, believe you me, Eric. In Penang, I had a funny feeling, but I wasn't being overconfident. The boat was running tidy, and I thought, well, we'll see what happens. And when it took off at the start, I thought, it's mine. Yeah, tell her I feel so good. And it's the dance of the day.
Just one for you.
promise.